You know, that's really good, and people calls you and wants to talk to you. That's a really good thing.
Oh, yeah.
It's not a bad thing.
You ready to go?
You ready? Mm-hmm. Let's say it's good to come to you. We appreciate you watching. We say this every week. We really enjoy coming, and this is one of our favorite parts of the week. When we get to come and look into God's Word, we appreciate you watching, and all the people that tells us every week, every single week, there's somebody that tells us that they're watching, or call us and tell us, or we're going to a business and they'll tell us they're watching. We appreciate everyone that watches, and there's a lot of people that, I mean, a lot of people that's told me we appreciate it, and I want to give you an invitation. Come be with us at Lacey's Chapel. We'd love to have you. Go to Henry Crossing, go 40 West, and it's the driveway will be 3 miles on your left. It's just Lacey's Chapel, and we'd love to have you, and we appreciate all of our church members, and a lot of them are watching, and we appreciate it, and we got people that watch us that used to go to a church, and they moved to other states, and we appreciate them watching. They still watch it on YouTube, so we appreciate everyone that watches and calls and tells us. We really do. So we're just glad that you're watching. If you got your Bibles today, I wanna look at something, and I think it's really going to bless you. I think it's really, really going to bless you what God has given me. We're still in John chapter 17, and we looked at this verse last week. Amen. I want to look at it again, but we're going to look at it from a little different angle. And I think it's really going to encourage you. John chapter 17, verse 4, Jesus said, "I have glorified thee on the earth. I have finished the work which thou gavest me to do." In verse 5, what we preached on last week, "Now, O Father, glorify thou me with thine own self, with the glory which I had with thee before the world was." And we talked about the glory that Jesus had before the world was, before the world was created. But we're talking about that Jesus had honor and glory with his Father before the earth was ever created. And we looked at that really, just the whole verse last week, about how Jesus was in creation and how nothing was created without him. And the Bible said everything was created for him. But we want to look at it today. That's what I want to talk about just for a few minutes, is we're talking about Jesus being glorified. We want to look at the message that heaven has sent to earth about Jesus. The message that heaven has sent to earth about Jesus. Remember, we talked about how Jesus was glorified in heaven, and let's look at the message that heaven sent to earth about Jesus. And we can look at this. We're talking about Jesus said in John 17, he's fixing to be arrested and crucified and give his life for us in John 17. And he prays before all of that happens. And he says, "Father, give me the glory that I had with you before the world was." So one last time, we talked about last week how he had glory before the world was, before creation. Well, we're going to look at the glory that he has in heaven and the message that God sent to earth, to me and you, from heaven, what heaven had to say about Jesus. Now, got your Bible, turn to Luke chapter 1 and verse 26. We're going to look at what heaven had to say about Jesus, but the message was to us. Luke 1 and 26, it said, "In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God into a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou art highly favored. And listen what the angel says to Mary. Thou art highly favored. The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Now, the angel didn't tell Mary, blessed art thou among gods. She wasn't a god, she was a girl. He said, blessed art thou among women. You know, that angel says, among women, you're blessed. He didn't say she was a deity that we was to pray to her. He said, blessed art thou among women. He said, you're a woman, but you're blessed. Verse 29, and when she saw him, she was troubled at her saying and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. Verse 30, and we're going to get some good stuff here. He said, fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. So the angel tells Mary, you have found favor with God. Blessed art thou among women. Again, she was a woman, not a god, not a deity that we to pray to. He said, blessed art thou among women. She was a woman. But he said, thou hast found favor with God. So whatever is fixing to happen, it's going to be God showing her favor. Now listen to this. It's good. Behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and shall bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. Now, he said, you found favor with God. You're going to conceive, you're going to bring forth a son, and you'll call his name Jesus. The angel is telling Mary, you found favor with God. In other words, he's telling her, you have found favor with God, and this is what's fixing to happen to you. This is what's going to happen to Mary because she has found favor with God. So, and this is what, now, then Gabriel tells her about Jesus. Here's what Gabriel tells Mary about the child that she's fixing to conceive. Here's what Gabriel says about Jesus. And I said at the very start of this, heaven's message to us about Jesus. What heaven had to say to us, to me and you, about Jesus. Now look what he said in verse 32. He shall be great. Now listen, heaven said, he shall be great. Well, that's what heaven said about Jesus. He shall be great. Well, the people, Isaiah prophesied, said in Isaiah 53, he says he's despised and rejected. He wasn't great in the eyes of the world. The Bible said by the world, he was despised and rejected, but he was great in the sight of God. You know, Gabriel's just telling Mary what God told him to tell her. All Gabriel is doing is relaying to Mary what God said about his son Jesus. Man, the Bible said, he is despised and rejected. That's what Isaiah 53 says. That's man. That was man's opinion of Jesus. It wasn't what God's opinion of him. Said he shall be great. Look at verse 32. And shall be called the Son of the Highest, or the Son of God. God said, this is my son. He shall be great, and he shall be called the Son of the Highest, or you could say the Son of God. What God had to say about Jesus to Mary was, he's great, and he's my son. So, I mean, God said, this is my son. You're going to conceive my son. And she's going to ask him, how's this be? I mean, I don't know. I've never had sexual relationship with a man. What she said, I've never known a man. And he says, the Holy Ghost will come upon you and you shall conceive. So, you know, he's saying, God is saying, he shall be great, and he shall be called the Son of the Highest. This is what Gabriel said, but he's only repeating what God told him to say. He said, he shall be great and shall be called the Son of the Highest. I was watching television one night, and they was interviewing this winner, and I don't remember if it was from American Idol or You Got Talent, or it was one of those shows where people compete and you have a winner, you know, at the end of the season. It's one of those shows, and you know, I was just amazed. They had this winner on there, and I was amazed at what he said. He said that final night, either was two or three contestants, you know, and this guy tells them, he says, one of you, of course, is going to win tonight. Said, there's one thing that we asked you. We're going to let you make a speech, but there's one thing that you're not allowed to do. That's what they told him. There's one thing that you cannot do. You cannot say the name of Jesus in your speech. That's what they told him. You know, there's one thing that you're not allowed to do. You're not allowed to say the name of Jesus. That's what, I don't remember if it was American Idol or You Got Talent. I don't remember which one of those it was. But this guy was giving, he was a Christian, he was giving his testimony. So the only thing they told us we could not say was the name of Jesus. That's the only thing he couldn't say. Well, you know, the Bible says, he, talking about Isaiah was prophesying about Jesus coming, said he is despised and rejected among men. In other words, man didn't, there were some people, of course, that received it. But the Bible said he came into his own, talking about the Jews, and they received him not. So, what God highly esteems, which was his son, the world didn't esteem him at all. But this is what God, this is what heaven said about Jesus. He shall be called great and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the last part of this verse, the last part of this verse hasn't been fulfilled yet, but it will be fulfilled. The last part of this verse says, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of David, the throne of his father David. So it's telling you God, Jesus is going to rule. He will rule. He's going to rule. He is Lord of Lords and King of Kings. He's going to rule. And it said, this hasn't happened yet, but it will happen. And we'll look at this more in the next week or two. But he is going to rule. He's coming back as Lord of Lords and King of Kings. And he is going to be in authority, and he will rule. The Word of God says he will. But it's amazing. This verse is really amazing because he said, he shall be called great. He shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give him the throne of his father David. Well, he hasn't even been conceived yet. I mean, Gabriel is telling her the Holy Ghost will come upon thee. He hasn't yet. But he's telling her, this is going to happen to you. The Holy Ghost is going to come upon you and you'll conceive. Well, this hasn't happened, but Gabriel's telling her it's going to happen. Because it was prophesied, behold, a virgin shall bring forth a child. You know, God used Mary to fulfill his prophecy. But in the prophecy, he says, and he shall, you know, he's going to inherit the throne of his father David. Look what it says. He said, the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. Even before Jesus was ever born, Gabriel said one day he's going to sit on David's throne and he's going to rule. And we'll look at that next week or two. But he will rule. He's coming back. He came the first time, you know, as the Lamb of God. In his life, he rode a donkey. The donkey was the animal of the servants. Because he said, I didn't come to be served, but I came to serve. Excuse me. He said, I didn't come to serve. Jesus said, but I didn't come to be served, but I came to serve. In other words, he came to serve others. It's what Jesus said. And he rode a donkey into his triumph entry into Jerusalem. Next time he's coming back as Lord of Lords and King of Kings. And John said, I see him on a white horse. Well, the horse was the animal of kings. Donkeys was the animal of servants. But one day he will rule. He is Lord of Lords. He is King of Kings. And all of these people that don't want to hear his name, they don't want you to speak the name of Jesus. They don't want to hear the name of Jesus. They blaspheme the name of Jesus and they mock the name of Jesus. Every single one of those people one day will fall down before him. The Bible says, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. Every single person that has rejected him will kneel down before him and say, you're Lord of Lords and King of Kings. Because the Word of God says throughout eternity, he's going to be in charge. He is going to rule. He said, he shall be great. He shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give. Look what he says. The Lord shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And I promise next week or two or three, we're going to look at that. Because I'm going to show you what the Word of God says. Look at verse 33. And he shall reign. Listen to this. Now listen to this. He shall reign over the house of Jacob or the house of Israel forever. This is what God says about him. He's going to rule over the house of Israel forever. See, let me just give you a thought right there. Can I? When Hitler was in power in the 1930s and 40s, he said he was going to exterminate the Jews. Didn't he? He sure did. Well, he didn't, did he? Well, the Word of God says right here, he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, or the house of Israel forever. They're not going to be destroyed. There's going to be a remnant of the Jewish people that God's going to protect. Hitler, you know, in his foolishness, thought he could destroy them in his hatred. You know, he was anti-Semitic. He hated the Jews. You know, caused a world war that killed millions. He wanted to destroy the Jews. I love this verse. He shall reign over the house of Israel, the house of Jacob forever. Well, it tells you that, I mean, in eternity, Jesus will rule over the house of Jacob forever. He's going to be Lord of Lords and King of Kings. When you pray to Jesus at night, you're praying the one that's going to rule throughout eternity. He's going to rule. The Word of God says he's going to rule forever. He's Lord of Lords and King of Kings. See, this is such good stuff. He shall rule over the house of Jacob forever. Now listen to what God says. And of his kingdom, there shall be no end. Oh, man, is this not wonderful stuff? Gabriel tells Mary, of his kingdom, it's never going to end. There's no end to his kingdom. Well, is that not what Jesus said? Let me show you something right here. Remember this verse, of his kingdom, there shall be no end. Mary said, the Gabriel said, he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, of his kingdom there shall be no end. Well, we can look at John, and everybody and their brother, everybody in the universe knows this name, knows this verse. Everybody in the world knows this verse, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believed in him should not perish, but have everlasting life, eternal life. Eternal life for eternity. So, Jesus is talking about everlasting life, eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believed in him should not perish, but have everlasting life, eternal life. Jesus said eternity is eternal. It's everlasting. You know, when you go to a funeral and that body is laying there, the Bible said to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. The Bible said when you die, you know, your body remains, but you go to be with the Lord if you're a Christian. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Paul said, I desire to depart and be with Christ, which is far better. Stephen was being stoned, and he said, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. He didn't say, I'm going to lay in a grave for 500 years. He's dying, and he says, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. Paul said, to be absent in the body is to be present with the Lord. So there's no question about what happens when a Christian dies. You know, when Jesus is talking about heaven and hell, he said a rich man died and in hell lifted his eyes. Didn't see he laid in the grave. He said the beggar died and was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom. Father Abraham, send someone to warn my brothers. Now listen to me. It's talking about a guy that had died. His body, they had the funeral. His body is buried. And he says, Father Abraham, why? I'm talking about the guy in hell. He says, Father Abraham, send someone to warn my brothers. At least they come to this place. He said, if someone goes and warns them, they'll repent. But what I'm saying is, why I've said all of this is, I'm trying to show you that a Christian, when you go to a funeral and someone has died, and they are a Christian, they're in eternity's forever. It's forever. If you're a Christian and you die, your problems are over the second that you die. The second that God comes gets you, I don't care what your problems are. The second that God comes gets you, your problems are over. It's over. The second that God comes gets you, you've had your last problem. You're over. Jesus said, he that believeth in me shall not perish, but have everlasting life, eternal life. Jesus said, he that believeth in me has eternal life. Well, that's what Jesus promised. Well, in Luke 1, Gabriel says, he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever. Of his kingdom there shall be no end, eternal. Heaven's message to us is, Jesus is going to rule through eternity. Through eternity. Eternity. Jesus said, he that believeth in me shall not perish, but have everlasting life, eternity. Jesus is saying, when you get saved, it's for eternity. I'll give him everlasting life. It's for eternity. See, this is so good. Gabriel is talking about, Jesus said, of his kingdom there'll be no end. It's eternal. It's eternity. So, we look at Mary, and Gabriel has told her all this stuff. Your son's going to rule for eternity. He's going to be called the Son of God. Man, is this not good stuff? Of his kingdom, there'll be no end. It's for eternity. You may be watching. You may be watching, and you may be going through a really tough time. You may be watching this morning, and you may be going through a really tough time. This week, I got some tough calls. People calling me for prayer, and some of them pretty bad. A lot of sickness going on. But Jesus, he is preparing heaven for eternity. You may go through some stuff down here. But heaven is for eternity. And if you miss heaven, it's for eternity too. Eternity. It's for eternity. He said, of his kingdom, there'll be no end. Eternity. You, like I said, you may be watching and you may be going through some stuff. You may be going through some stuff. But when God takes you home, when God brings you home, it's over. Your life's problem is over. I'm fixing the clothes. And if you're watching, you're going through some stuff, listen to me. I feel the Holy Ghost, I do. Heaven's forever. Heaven's forever. It's for eternity. It's for eternity. I don't care what you go through, heaven be worth it. It's for eternity. So this time next week, may God bless you. Get a chance to be with Salacious Chapel. Goodbye. Thank you, brother.
Like a bird in prison I dwell. No fear.